welcome back to What Are Geographic Information Systems, or What is GIS? I'm Dr. Heath Robinson. In a previous lesson, I talked about what geographic information systems are in the round. I kind of gave you an idea about the big idea of geographic information systems, but I didn't actually define them. That's what I want to do in this lesson. Actually, not providing a definition of geographic information systems is rather common. You can find a lot of textbooks on GIS that explicitly say how difficult it is to define what a geographic information system is, simply because the field is very broad and any particular GIS may take a variety of different forms. And so they instead prefer to talk about geographic information systems sort of in the round, as I did in previous lessons. And this certainly alone can be very helpful in sort of understanding what it is that a course in geographic information systems will talk about, especially for students who don't have a clear idea about what a course in GIS may entail if they're just coming in. So many instructors choose to go ahead with this sort of basic understanding of GIS in the round. So I'm going to buck the trend here of GIS instruction and actually provide you with a definition of what I think geographic information systems are. I think that it is possible to do, and I also think that it's valuable to do. Not only so you have this idea of what a geographic information system is, so you know one when you see it, but also I want you to know that although this is a broad field, although they can take many different forms, it's not a field without a focus. There is a core to what a geographic information system is, and I can provide you with that definition. So previously we said that the core of geographic information systems is using computers to solve geographic problems or answer geographic questions. I want to get a bit more technical now and actually talk about the definition of geographic information and system in order to move forward. I think that it's very necessary to do in order to lay a foundation so that everyone knows exactly what the field is going to be about, what the course is going to cover, and so they have something to build upon, and they don't get into a very narrow track with GIS about just the functionality or the operations of a particular software system. All right, so let's get started. What are geographic information systems? Let's provide that definition. As I just mentioned, it's pretty common for GIS textbooks not to give a definition of geographic information system, and sometimes even claim that it's impossible to provide such a definition because of the wide variety of forms that geographic information systems can take. Further, even in those few situations where one does find a definition of geographic information system given, it's not very uncommon for those definitions to be rather poor and unsatisfying. For instance, an information system designed for geographic information. Now, this is a bit of an exaggeration because it's such a terrible definition, but it's not much of one. I have seen many different definitions of GIS that come pretty close to being this bad. With a definition like this, you might as well not have one at all. Obviously, this is a terrible definition because it contains the words that we're trying to define. If you are trying to define geographic information system, you cannot use the words geographic or geography or information or system. Instead, we have to look at each of these parts individually to see what they mean. So that's exactly what I'm going to do, but I'm going to do this in reverse order. First, I'm going to specify what it means for something to be a system, and then what information is, so we know what it means to be an information system, and then we will talk about what it means for something to be geographic, so we can put it all together into geographic information system. So the first order of business in defining geographic information system is to define system. To do this, I just started with some basic dictionary definitions. In general, a system is a set of connected things or parts forming a more complex whole. And that definition does seem to make a lot of sense. When one thinks about the respiratory system, for example, one is thinking about a set of organs that are all connected so that they form a more complex whole.
Dictionaries often also provide a definition of system that specifically relates to computers. And since we are talking about computer systems, broadly speaking, in geographic information systems, I want to specify the definition of system that we're using so that it specifically addresses some of the particular concerns of computers. When one speaks about a computer system, we're talking about a set of related computer hardware and software, especially when it's dedicated to a single application. So what I want to do is I want to blend these two definitions together to give us our foundational definition of system that we will use to define geographic information system. For our purposes here, then, let's say that a system is a set of related computer hardware and software connected to form a more complex whole. Now, these interrelated hardware and software components will be dedicated to a single application, so we're going to want to specify exactly what it is they're doing as we continue with this definition. We'll do that as we go on. But with this general understanding of system, we'll move on to looking at what is information. In GIS, we're not just talking about any system, and we're not talking about computer systems in general either. We're specifically talking about information systems, and so it's important for us to understand what information is. What is information? Is it data? Is information a synonym for data? Well, if they mean exactly the same thing, if they are perfect synonyms, then it wouldn't help our definition all that much just to swap out data for information, since I wouldn't be giving you any additional content. But fortunately for us, there is a difference between data and information. Actually, the distinction between data and information is a big topic, but I just want to give you the flavor of the difference here. Information is data with value added. If you take data and interpret it in some way and add meaning to it, then you're generating information. There are lots of techniques that can be used to collect vast amounts of data. And we're often considered to be living in the age of big data. So depending on what you're trying to study, it is possible to be overwhelmed with the quantity of data that you've got. If, for instance, you're busting apart atoms in the Large Hadron Collider, or you're trying to collect all of the tweets and Facebook status updates and similar things across all social media, or even if you're running a constellation of satellites that are orbiting the Earth and constantly beaming back data. These are instances where you can just be awash in data. The Shuttle Radar Topography mission collected a tremendous amount of data about the elevation of the surface of the Earth all around the planet, but it was not the case that when the shuttle landed, they just opened up the cargo bay and started handing out topographic maps. No, there was still a tremendous amount of effort that people had to go through to get that raw data that was collected by the shuttle into usable information. So it can be potentially easy to get lots of data, but just having all that downloaded and sitting on a hard drive, unexplored, uninterpreted, and without some kind of value added to it, you don't have information. So I want us to think of data as a foundation. If we don't have data, we're not going to be able to get anywhere in GIS. We've got to be able to acquire it, and as I said, depending on what you're studying, the acquisition of the data can either be easy or hard, but if you don't have the data, you're not going to be able to progress. Once we add value to this data, once we begin to organize it, once we begin to interpret it, and once we begin to add value to it, then we get information. Information is understandable, whereas raw data is not readily understandable, or not as easily understandable. We are talking about an information system here, and so we're talking about a system that has the capability of importing data and viewing it, of course, but it also has the functionality that we need to allow us to add the necessary value to get information. So in this sense, information is a layer on top of data. I like to put a third layer on top of information. Just having information is often not the final objective. Often you want to add even more value to your information. You often generate knowledge. That's ultimately where we want to move in many GIS projects. It's very often the case that people want knowledge about something and realize the techniques and methods of geographic information science can help them get it. People who have put Earth observation satellites in orbit that are constantly beaming back data to Earth didn't do that just for the sake of having terabytes and terabytes and terabytes of data taking up space on a hard drive someplace, but because they hope that by having that data they can use it and ultimately derive knowledge about some subject. The purpose of a computer system that we're discussing is not only then to help us move from data to information, but also from information to knowledge. So information sits here at the second level, right between the lower level data and the higher level knowledge, and so we get two different interfaces here, one where information is interfacing with the lower level data, and one where information is interfacing with the higher level knowledge. Therefore, we want an information system to help us create information from data, but also to help us process that information further and generate knowledge. Actually, I like to add a fourth layer on top of knowledge. If you add more value to knowledge, then you can get to wisdom. That is, in an ultimate sense, what many people are pursuing on an intellectual level. Ultimately, people want wisdom. But in this course and in further courses in GIS, I'm not going to talk much about wisdom. If you really want to talk about what wisdom is, and there's plenty to say, I recommend a philosophy course. But you could at least see where the computer systems that we are developing as a society might contribute to the development of wisdom, even though we're going to be talking about and operating on a much lower level in this course. All right, so we need to talk about what it is the information system needs to be able to do, what kind of functionality that it needs to have, to enable us to move from data to information and information to knowledge. That's exactly what we'll cover next.